are no discussions on the agenda. We have three subjects: the Eastern Partnership, Afghanistan, and Venezuela. Of course, in the margin of our discussions, we'll look at it. Our position is a very clear position. We believe that we should do our best in order to find a solution. If there is a need for an extension of the period, from our part as presidency of the Council, we'll prepare all the necessary logistics for continuing the discussions on Brexit.
So would you be up for a long extension in that case, if necessary?
Long extension, we can't extend it outside our presidency, which is the 31st of June, 30th of June.
Okay. On Libya, sir, is the EU fighting a losing battle here?
On Libya? For the time being, we are trying to put together the different elements in Libya. We'll continue to support the idea of having elections, constitutional reform, and we'll try to support all those who are involved in Libya in the politics.
Just on Brexit again, has Theresa May shown you a convincing way forward yet? Do you think she has a plan?
I do not exclude the possibility of having an extraordinary council at the level of the European Union to take into account the proposals of Madame Theresa May. And on this basis, we can look into the future and the possibilities to arrive at the conclusion.
Morning.
Do you think that, that the peace process or the UN plan still valid today, or it is finished?
It is valid from my point of view. There is a special representative for Libya, and as I already said, our preoccupation is to put together the different actors in Libya and try to find the solutions through elections, having a new constitution which will offer the possibility of Libya to overcome the difficulty.
The European Union is sanctioned against this part or the other part?
We have never discussed about taking sides. We never discussed at the level of the European Union for taking sides on one part or the other. Sorry?
About this third party, we are discussing today. Can you tell us about the progress made by the and can you tell us more about the meeting which will be in that May?
Yes, I do not hide the fact that for us, for Romania, one of the top priorities is the Eastern Partnership. We are very happy that we have put on the agenda today the preparations for the ministerial summit in Brussels next month, and will continue to support strongly the idea of having a final document which will take stock of what happened during the Eastern Partnership in these 10 years from its creation, to also refer to the important developments which took place in the territories of our partners, and from the point of view of those who are already advanced, those who signed association agreements with the European Union, it's also to encourage them to continue and to support their efforts. From this point of view, because you are asking for Georgia, Georgia is one of the countries which practically now, today, it's in a very good position. It's the premiant, it's the first one on the list of those who are our partners in the East.
You mentioned the
talk I think that the matter of Libya is a matter of
conflict.
We must cut the violations as soon as possible.
We have prepared a draft document which is circulated now. It will be transmitted, conveyed to all the Eastern partners, and we'll see which are the proposals and try to arrive at a common approach on all the issues. I know every country has some priorities, and we hope we can accommodate them in this statement.
What is next for Georgia?
No, what we want is to give a very clear signal that there is a perspective for all these partners to see into the future their possibility of joining the European Union, but at the same time from our point of view, what we can do is to support the positive evolutions in all these countries, because these evolutions are not for the countries, are for the citizens of these countries, and we are strongly supporting the advancement on the, on this issue. Thank you, thank you. Bună dimineața! Da, sigur, vă spunem tot ce vă interesează. Deci, pe agenda Consiliului pentru Afaceri Externe sunt trei puncte principale: parteneriatul estic, Afganistan și, bineînțeles, Venezuela. Din punctul nostru de vedere, prioritatea pentru România la actuala sesiune, prioritatea maximă este parteneriatul estic. Dorim ca la ministeriala din luna mai să avem un document care să țină cont, să încerce să facă o evaluare a tuturor măsurilor care au fost întreprinse în acești 10 ani, să discutăm despre viitor și să pregătim pentru perioada după 2020, când se încheie parteneriatul estic, să avem pentru viitoarea comisie niște perspective foarte clare în legătură cu politica de parteneriat estic pentru toate cele 6 țări, 3 care au acorduri de asociere, Moldova, Ucraina și Georgia, și 3 care sunt într-o relație de dezvoltare cu Uniunea Europeană, cum e Belarus, Armenia și Azerbaidjan. Asta este principala noastră preocupare. Am elaborat un proiect de document care să fie adoptat la viitoarea reuniune ministerială și acum suntem în discuții cu partenerii noștri estici în legătură cu eventuale amendamente pe care doresc să le includă în document.
Mulțumesc frumos!
O zi bună!